Alhaji, you must calm down and tell me exactly what is eating you up.
But I have been informed that you are nursing the idea of creating a ministry for the oil producing states. I want to know what that means.
Oh, it means exactly what you heard.
I am sorry, Your Excellency, you are the President, no doubt. But I'm sure that you are not unaware of the fact that there are certain decisions that you cannot make without consulting stakeholders like me.
But Elijah, this is one problem I would like to solve as a President without involving the so-called stakeholders.
We have problems in the oil producing areas. Oil workers are getting kidnapped. And the economy has been slowly drowned.
And it's only imperative that I step in as the commander-in-chief of this country and solve this issue.
Mr. President, are you trying to tell me that you have already created this ministry?
Alhaji, as we speak, I am trying to pen down a competent hand to run this young ministry.
I would like to see you first thing in the morning.
Alhaji, you know you need no appointment to get to the presidential villa.
As long as I'm in town, you can see me whenever you choose to.
I shall be there 9 a.m. First thing.
Very well, Alhaji. See you there.
This is unacceptable.
We don't want any new ministry coming to help us solve the confusion.
Sir, if I may advise you, I think you should keep away from Alhaji Gambo and men in his category who feel they can dictate to any government that is in place.
You have a point, Mrs. Ryan, but you must understand that the likes of Alhaji Gambo are not men to be ignored.
I guess you're right, Your Excellency. But this present government is very popular. The people love us, sir. And you have to know that ultimate power rests with the people. Alhaji Gambo and his cohorts cannot bring down this present government, Your Excellency. You should have seen how excited the people are at the mere mention of the creation of a ministry that will cater for the oil-producing states. It's amazing, sir. I think what we should be doing now, sir, is intensify our efforts to get a competent hand that will run the ministry.
I agree. Yes.
Yes. Why bring me come this kind of place when be like say we, the war does start already? This is our dead end now.
I invited you here because I want us to talk like brothers. Now you and me start this struggle, and I'm still committed to that arrangement. I want us to talk like brothers in the same struggle.
Listen, I already issued a statement telling them that I'm only ready to work with those who want a good conscience and a human face.
Exactly what I'm telling you, Perry. You see, a born fighter does not wine and dine with oppressors. You hear me? A government from the line of oppressors cannot metamorphose into anything different. Yes. And I'm telling you as a brother, I want you to stop that romance with the government henceforth.
Why? Have you forgotten? Initially, when we started the struggle, that you and I knew quite well that our main concern was to get the government to look our way.
So, can you vouch for anything to show that they are looking at our way?
Surely they, you know they get eye to see.
What in there to see?
Ah, oh boy, the ministry where they get now Now for people we no get money for the oil producing areas where you go the mayanga before you go feed the mayanga again for these people. They are my people. Now they get the land. They don't create ministry. We be saying now they are own. Or you know they go there. Look, now credible statement in the right direction. Now you, Mr. President, make so. Let's we could give them the benefit of the doubt. Sure you did now.
So now waiting you to tell all these boys where they follow you. You did tell them so that one I go to pick cobble from under government table. Now that one go belly fool you. Are you listening to him?
Perry, I think you've missed the point.
What point?
You've lost it. Because we were right here when they created Mopadek. And what came out of it? Nothing. And then they moved on with another stupid one. Oil Producing Development Commission. That thing was a failure. And what makes you think, suddenly, that this ministry has anything good to offer us?
You don't know what thing they happen. I can tell you. All those things where they talk, no enter. The ministry we did now better pass any other parastatal where you don't mention so. You hear me so? This ministry, they take care of the 7-point agenda. Now, the very only one with the priority list. When Mr. President no say, must take care of the poor children where the area where the oil there for the come. You hear me so? I mean to tell you, this president, now the only president where me know say, he better pass the other ones. We don't thief wrong come out for this place now.
True talk.
What did they tell? You hear me so?
True talk.
Look, make we give him chance, make it continue.
See, Perry, let me tell you something, and I'm talking to you as a brother. It is very clear that your intention is to betray our struggle. Very clear. But I have a message for you. Man, we cut your papa head because of land. You not go waste 1 minute to cut you into pieces if you venture into that same land.
Tell her making here.
Tell her.
You know as it be. Who not go, not know as it be.
No.
Try tell her making here.
The last thing I want to tell you with that.
Make I tell you something. The next time you carry me, come this guy place, say una they invite me for meeting again. Could see what I would do.
Something tells me that Braye is out to sabotage our struggle. All the rubbish he said about this nonsense ministry did not make any sense to me at all. I mean, if you ask me, I think we should just end him and know that we have only one problem, and that is the government.
Sorry, I don't agree with you, my friend.
Perry is our brother. We cannot afford to kill one of our own. He will not be the first to toe this line. The best thing to do is to avoid him, knowing fully well that to get close to him will lead to something sinister.
Do you know why I asked for you?
No, sir.
I am becoming very uncomfortable with the policies of your boss. He is going off the track. We must bring him on course before he commits a grave mistake.
Alhaji, you're talking as if all has gone wrong.
Exactly, Mr. Uche. All has gone wrong. Otherwise, why will the president reduce the exalted office of the commander-in-chief into a negotiating avenue? Decisiveness is one of the qualities required of a president. And I have come to the conclusion that he is very short on that.
Alhaji, you are descending so heavily on the commander-in-chief. Sincerely, I don't know what to say.
He's beginning to negotiate with terrorists, and that is permanently unacceptable.
Terrorists? Alhaji, who are these terrorists?
They are the useless militants who call themselves representatives of the oil-producing areas. Now, any negotiation he has with them amounts to negotiating with terrorists, and that is not acceptable.
Alhaji, I must say that these are very strong views that you have here. Have you managed to communicate these views to Mr. President?
Oh, I'm having a meeting with him first thing tomorrow morning. But I thought I should come and get you informed.
I have invested over 1 billion naira into getting him into that office. Now, I am not going to sit by and let my money be chopped by somebody. I have not got back one kobo of that money. Nothing. And no one is going to chop my money. I'm going to recoup all my investment plus profit. Kanajina? There you are.
I came in yesterday and my secretary said you came looking after me. I don't know, is there anything the matter?
Well, I was quite disappointed when I heard that you went to visit Alhaji Gambo.
Why would you be disappointed that I've gone to see Alhaji Gambo?
Why in this world would you want to visit a man that is trying to bring down the government that puts food on your table? Come on, Uche. You are a bona fide member of this government, and you should know better.
Are you aware that this Alhaji Gambo you are castigating in your office is the very, as in the very principal godfather that installed Mr. President in office?
Oh no, I quite disagree with you, Jay.
Really?
The people that put the government in power are the masses. And when I say the masses, I mean the people in the office. The market woman in the market and the people on the streets. Those are the people that the president owes his allegiance to. Not the likes of Alhaji Gambo and his cohorts who are always there to just destabilize every government.
You are singing. You know what? You are living in the dark and you have to wake up. Elections don't hold in this country. Are you listening to me? Men like Alhaji Gambo decide who stay anywhere.
Uche, you're not talking like a Democrat.
The way I talk is not going to change something that is known and established in this country. There are men that own this country and they decide who stays in power. You have to see Alhaji Gambo as a godfather and not as a mere man, not just as a mere Alhaji. You have to see him as a godfather.
You know, someone once told me you're a military apologist, and I didn't believe him. But now you stand to prove me wrong.
I don't know what you mean by a military apologist, because I've never served any military government in my life. But there is something you have to understand. You have to get Mr. President to understand that Alhaji Gambo is a force to reckon with. He can do and don't do.
Good day, Mrs. Rahim.
What a joke.
But Alhaji Gambo, I mean, you and I know that we only have this one country, see, and that, see, the past governments, they've always treated the problems of the oil-producing area as if there are no problems. Now, I have adopted a different strategy, which is why I recruited this ministry.
And where do you want to place the head office of this new ministry?
Head office? Oh, it only makes sense to put the head office in one of the states of the producing areas.
I do beg your pardon, Your Excellency. You see why I always say that you are wrongly advised. Your Excellency, there is a standing law which says that any major establishments being set up
must have its head office at the federal capital.
So I said to myself, why? Why would His Excellency in the world think of putting the head office in the bedroom of terrorists?
Alas, Gambo, please. That is absolutely ludicrous. Now, you know that these are bona fide citizens of this country, fighting for what rightfully belongs to them. You and I know that. Now, why? Why in the world would you or anyone refer to them as terrorists, Alhaji? Why?
Your Excellency, you and I must not argue over anything.
Oh, we shouldn't.
If you have decided you want to set up this ministry, and you're convinced, then so be it.
Good.
But let it be settled in your mind, Your Excellency, that I shall appoint the minister.
I beg your pardon. Alhaji Gambo, please listen to me very carefully. This here is one ministry that is very close to my heart. And I will not allow anyone, and I mean anyone, to play politics with the ministry. Nobody!
Your Excellency.
Yes, what?
I'm sorry to interrupt, please. Your Excellency, I have bad news for you. My liaison officer at Bayaka State just called me. He said that the Ukweli gas plant that we're about to commission has just been blown up.
Blown up?
Yes, that's the information that I just got.
See? You see why I said these people are terrorists? You see them? Do you know the value of what they have just blown up? I think we should just get these people and fall on them like a ton of bricks.
You get me the IG immediately. Yes, get me my chief security officer immediately.
Your Excellency, you don't need these people to stabilize this country. You need people like us who are committed to your progress and prosperity.
What's the problem?
But say they
waiting.
They don't blow the gas plant too. Who? Okay, everyone, they don't die. And people say this is the gang against us.
Oh God! Why are they doing this to a president that means well?
We face us there.
Then say water.
Go tell Festus and the rest of the gang. Make you carry this guy to come. Meet me for cream.
Okay.
Yeah, be so.
Just yesterday, the Venezuelan president confirmed to me that he'll be arriving for the commissioning of this plant. A whopping $16 billion invested in that plant. It was meant to be the best of its kind in Africa. Now, it's blown up just like that. Now, what picture does that paint of our security system in this country?
Your Excellency, I think the best thing to do is to inform the President of the new development.
Mrs. Ryan, that information smacks of instability. I am trying everything to show to the world that we have stability in this nation. Why? Now, why are they doing everything possible to undermine that effort? Why?
Your Excellency, sir, the information at my disposal shows that we can still proceed with the commissioning exercise.
Commission what? What are we commissioning? The plant has been blown up.
They killed a policeman. I am beginning to see reasons why I must take these miscreants head on and crush them.
I'm sorry, Your Excellency, but that would be counterproductive. I still believe that dialogue is the best option here.
Exactly.
Mr. Jones, I have always listened to you. You know that. But I no longer see reason why I must continue with this option of dialogue. This miscreant that they're undermining the efforts of my administration. And I think it is time that I crush them!
Matter. You fire your hand. You hear me, Mr. Braye? Who you be, sir? You know how much money the government does spend on total gas plant? You don't know.
I don't care how much government spend for that gas plant.
Why did they go blow them up?
Of what use is it to our people?
What is they talk
now? Of what use? You, why you not fit be manager for that gas plant? Why they not employ you? You not go to school? You don't qualify. Why you not a work there?
God, Braye, you surprise me. Since you the yard, Braye, oh you, the old Capone, and the yard like this. You know if you deny the fact, say, that plant, now ain't they useful in the past, now ain't they give us the money where they take by arms. Braye, you go school past most of us here now. Which one you want to tell me again?
If you admit, say, I go school and I get sense, then you will give it to me, say, I know what you have to do. You hear him?
Wait, please, I be waiting you to do. I need to go blow up gas plant where they serve the purposes of the future of our children, of our country, of our own land! Surprise me.
See, make I tell you something. Something where you already know. The only reason for that gas plant is to continue the evacuation of our God-given resources. On a daily basis, they pollute our environment. They destroy our farmlands. Look at our parents. They're nowhere to farm, nowhere to fish. Yet, billions of money, they enter some stupid people's pocket where they don't give a damn about us around here. You see me, they build gas plant. Gas plant for who? Who they employ here? Which of us will not go to school here? Yeah, they employ us there. Right. We not qualify.
Information from the presidency. Now we be people. We be lawyers to the president. We not the super people, the men, the henchmen. They may they go tell the children, say, all the youth that where they land go inside river. They all go get employment. Now you they go blow up your whole food. They got your whole hand.
Today. Big boss, no verse. Perez, wouldn't be your problem. Wouldn't be your problem. We cannot continue in that service. No be possible. It's our wealth. And we determine who gets what. Who be those people? I say you be director, you be manager. And who are we? And let our youth be mere workers? Not anymore. No be possible. Go tell them. Tell them. Say we are determined to take charge of our destiny. Straight away.
No boy. You not small boy, you're the young. You know say before me, I'll pass you.
But then leave all this way they talk. Leave all this way they talk. Where they worry you now? Eh? Where they worry you? Eh?
What is your problem? Look, ma, I tell you now, so then would they pull on her like kite. Then would they pull on her like kite. We need to talk about whether you hot or not. we talk about what thing they happen now. The injustice where they happen to our people.
Yes.
You feel me? Make I say we go fight anybody, we go challenge anything, we go challenge, and nothing will happen for this town. You dey feel me? You dey hear?
Let them not make you guys for this town, put to God. So they want to rake here, what will happen if you get it? What's done, John?
Make I tell you, make you listen well. If you get the task spirit, like we all. Yeah? It is first thing, make you listen, say that defeat the big for you to the challenge of fight man will be well for you, that the future of your children. Which one you tell me?
Which man went me well for me? Which man? Which man?
Mr. President, we well for everybody.
I beg, leave all this way they talk, I beg.
So.
Leave all this way they talk. They're not a deceiver now. They're a deceiver now. And they open the gate, let them come out, John.
They'll close that gate! I don't know where I'm going. I don't know what you did. Let me tell you something. You go realize this thing, but you go down late by day. When you and me start this thing, we agree. Say now, a properly articulated development master plan. Now then go begin implement. A master plan devoid of any kind of manipulative tendency. You know, say now the right thing with that. And that is what we are fighting for.
Life.
Nothing more. We not want anybody bribe.
Life.
And until they do that, we will continue to torment them. We will bring this economy to a standstill.
Life.
You say you get access to them. Tell them, say, now what you talk with that.
You see, Alhaji, if I am asked to say, I will say that Jones is not our main problem. Mrs. Zainab Rahim, the Honorable Minister of Information, is the problem we have.
She is the one misleading the President. And I think the time is ripe for you to use your powers to get rid of her.
Now tell me, Uche, how exactly do you want it? You want us to remove her completely out of existence? Or do you want us to cripple her and have her sent off the corridors of power?
Alhaji, I think I will leave you to use your discretion to fashion out the best thing to do. But I just want you to understand that her presence is not in our overall interest.
Dialogue will make Mr. President to continue to look towards the oil producing area. And that is exactly what Mrs. Rahim wants. Alhaji, I want you
to unleash military might against the militants. When this is done, Alhaji, they will go under. And there will be confusion in the land. There will be a kind of tension in the country. And business can go unhindered. Business can go unhindered.
Yes, business can go unhindered. Wallahi tallahi, I'm very glad to hear that. Uche, Uche!
Alhaji Kambo.
Done. Oh yes, consider it done.
Look, this man we're talking about here is a senior special advisor in the presidency on security matters in the oil producing areas, and we cannot afford to keep him waiting.
Yes, I agree, but we must articulate what we must tell him.
I don't understand, but
something tells me that he's here to psych us up. And we must follow him with a strong application of diplomacy. You don't understand?
Well, you know, he's here to identify with us like he used to do in the past. And he also knows that we are not the ones responsible for the explosion at the gas plant.
Yes, but he won't make Uyana and the way they're responsible now. And I'm saying that we cannot do that. Eh? Now to say we and Dombra don't disagree, but you cannot afford to betray our brothers. It's never done.
Well, me, I don't get intention to betray anybody, but maybe we go inside and go talk about them.
My friend, sorry to keep you waiting. How you doing?
No
problems. Okay. Welcome, eh? Oh, make we here for you now.
I want you to understand that I'm here in my individual capacity as Martins Jones and not in my official capacity as the senior special assistant to the president.
See the movement there. Let me say we almost did together. I never reached you in your turn yet. Yes. But we just put everything in a small nutshell.
But where to carry your two legs go here?
Could you tell me the identity of those that blew up the ultramodern gas plant?
My friend, you know, the river too big.
And you know easy. Because now you put fish inside water. But fish plenty.
But we could help you locate anybody where we just say now in there do that nonsense.
We don't need them for punishment. We need them for negotiation. See, we are lucky to have the president that have a listening ear. He has said it time and time again that he's out for dialogue. That is why I left the capital city, to let you know that violence don't pay.
Oh, you get sense that we self get to say sense now. You know, no say we self now peace ambassadors with you. We did fight for equity, justice, fairness, so that we can have you. Your children will be happy for fraud even when we don't go ever. You have to.
Anyway, we get access to local and international weaponry.
Whether an IAF fighter jets, naval warships, submarines, IRPGs, GPMGs, M16, many things they will get. But we know they say we won't use our. What would say we say? But they use that for people we don't agree we own.
So, what if we say we will do it? We will try to see where we can fit, call the youth leaders that make them do meetings, and we'll fit, try to see if we locate any one of them where they do that nonsense. Yeah?
I arrived here with good money. I will give you money. But I want you to plead to the violent network to cease fire. They should drop their weapon. Let them understand that violence doesn't pay, but dialogue answers to all.
Now, true you talk, me self agree with you now, we'll go tell them. In fact, so, but make we have to go tell those youth leaders them. So maybe they call meetings with their small boys and say, I won't talk to them, yeah? So no shaking at all, no worry yourself. When you tell our guy president, say, we day, can't wait, we day for that.
That man, Mr. Sabatis Jones, now President Zellam, and we will work with President, because he knows that man of the whole world. Wait till me they try to tell you, say that man, a special advisor on security matters for presidency. My man, is that you? Me they talk to you now. With that money there. Accept this thing as one small token. They could have stopped the day. Destroy your information that passes the baby. Baggy!
You're not interested in your book.
See, maybe tell this small boy. When did they inside this bag? Now tell me the naira that I face bag. Now sporting with me.
And as for two of them, where they follow Perel like saying, people, you know, you get sense, Pastor.
First thing, reason I'm all.
Take your money and get away from here.
Now 10 million, baby, so. No, not reason I'm all.
Oh boy.
That's 10 million, bro.
If the money, don't give them again.
Take your money.
Carry the money.
Not gonna carry this money.
Carry the money, they go. Where we go? Where we go?
Where
we
go?
Where we go? Where we go?
Where we go? Where
we go? Where we go? Where we go? Where we go? Where Braye, we go see you later, yeah? You don't pull your hand now, you don't pull your hand.
You know as it be.
You don't pull your hand.
You know as it
is. You go see now.
Okay.
How they go?
If you're telling me that they're not ready to work with the government, then we may be forced to crush them.
My friend, which can crush? What's waiting?
My own people. You crush my people, I'll crush my country. Who touched them now, we can see. I know Sabi cool down, Abi. My friend, now they tell you, see, we all, we gather collect money. No, only one group, we no collect. I don't know whether that they go bump any gas plant. They tell you, of course, if you try not since you, you will die, boy.
Is it the same group that blew up the gas plant?
How would know? I've told you before, say, me, I promise you, and I'm still committed to that promise. Sure, sure you day now. Don't make so. When I reach, we go know whether not them or be na whoever. Me, I don't know who they be.
If they are not the same group, why then did they reject the money?
Why they no go reject them? Why they no go reject them? How many times when I go talk something from mouth, go do another thing? Look, the government of the past years, they don't disappoint these people, my people, many times. That's who? You know? It's okay. We go to this. The light safety today, we look for light. We look for water. No, crude oil, they take fight up and down, so. When it be say, it then yafu yafu full backyard for everybody else. Who be the thief? Who be the owner?
Me, I don't know whether that them we refuse the money that they go blow up the gas plant. I don't know yet.
But you know that this president means well.
I know. But they don't! Because they've been hurt! They don't use them tire where they say they don't know forgiveness again. How they go blame them? Or you both go come their land where then we get money, or you both go the million girl for them, then the grace will be on you both. But boy, stop those things. Oh, let me go carry go here now.
Look, the majority of the youth then deal with the president. Me, then they serve me, and me be their oga. Who you give me small time so that her feet romance their wounds. Because the wound too deep. Hey, you see.
I had already told him that, but want to see the communicated support translate into a glaring peace. The youth cannot say that they are supporting the president at the same time sabotaging his efforts.
My friend, if you don't believe me, you don't come my house again. You hear me so?
See, I believe you 100%. That is why I'm always coming back to you. So many people are already accusing us that we are adopting the wrong strategy. I mean, the strategy of engaging you guys into a dialogue. But we are continuing because we know that it's only dialogue that can settle this problem we have at hand.
Hey, make I tell you, God punish those people where they talk that nonsense. Who them be? They don't even reach my shoe. Why they no come out, God, they talk? They talk for night inside backyard. Yeah, yeah, people. Look, go back, go tell Mr. Presido. See me, Bere. Bucket. Me tell her, say, make it give us more time. Me, I go ginger other stories, make it for day happy. But for now, he ain't get the use, no wahala day. As long as they keep your word with the fear of God, no shaking.
I'll communicate that to the president.
Your Excellency, I don't have much information on Don Braye Silva.
Well, I do. Don Braye Silva is the leader of the group that blew up the gas plant and killed 20 mobile policemen. I now have information on them to know that that is the one group that have refused to work with my government.
Your Excellency, what do you intend to do about that?
I have ordered his arrest. Well, you need not be surprised. The IG has been briefed accordingly. I only call you here as the Minister for Information to put you on the know.
But, Your Excellency, we can't afford to go back on the dialogue option. I mean, we can't afford to go back to the same way, old ways that old government have been using.
This is right. That old pattern we're talking about provided us with stability. And I am interested in the stability of this country.
Every time we try to dialogue with these people, they intensify their effort to undermine our governmental efforts.
I crave your indulgence, Your Excellency, but I have here a comprehensive security report on these people, which shows that each time the government tries to work with them by force, it always backfires. And it's always to the detriment of the government.
Mrs. Ryan, I am not interested to dialogue any further or deliberate any further on this matter. As the president and commander-in-chief of this country, I have made my decision, and my decision has been communicated to all relevant government agencies. Now, what I need for you to do is hold down your office as the Minister for Information. Now, am I getting across to you?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Good.
Can you tell me what the problem is, Mrs. Rahim? You can confide in me.
Uche, the president has called off the dialogue option. He has ordered for the arrest of Dombraye Silva. Now we're back to the evil days.
I am terribly surprised that you are bothered over that. What Mr. President did is the right thing, Mrs. Rahim.
What do you mean by the right thing?
Listen to me. The president has no reason whatsoever engaging economic saboteurs to a dialogue. He's Dombraye Silva. His arrest is going to serve as a deterrent to other members of or other militia groups in the oil producing area who are doing everything possible to undermine this government.
Uche, do you realize that the arrest of Dombraye Silva will trigger off reprisals that will ultimately create instability in the oil regions?
Mrs. Rahim, we have joint presidential task force on ground in the oil producing areas. And these men are competent to handle any nonsensical reprisal, whatever that is going to come from these idiots, parading themselves as militants. Listen to me, what Mr. President did is the right thing. Put that man behind bars.
I can't believe you're saying this, Uche.
Man, do you know what? We are lucky in that we are privileged to be in positions where we have access to information. Just relax and watch what is going to happen in this country in the next few weeks. Relax and you will see. Mrs. Rahim, have a wonderful day.
What's going on here? Oh my God.
I'm sorry, my able commander, but I don't understand this.
What is that? Listen to this. Maybe your eyes don't play you blind. The president orders the inspector general to arrest Dombraye Silva.
Shebi, I tell you, say make you know disclose his full identity. Why would you do this? What do you stand to gain if they kill Dombraye?
I know this. Close Dombraye identity to anyone. Tell me that, right?
You won't deny this one, but you cannot deny it. It's very, very clear. See, this is the graphical details of everything where me I am with you in privacy. I don't talk to any other person now. Habba, Pere. I don't talk to any other person. There is no way the presidency could have heard what I discussed with you in privacy if you had not disclosed the information to Mr. Jones. Why would you do that?
Hey! I know who said.
Shey, you sabi say these guys are fighting the same emancipation with us.
Boy. Because now we start up. And I know sent. I no give a damn! And me blow that whistle on Dombraye's black ass. Because the guy no get better head. You hear me too? President, we be say, just entered
bring change for good for you and the future of your children, then talk say he promised not to go that Niger Delta, clean every dirty we did there, make the place they shine like Obodo Ibo overseas their people. So Ibo will call the Mayanga for you. Your children life will better they shine for front. Even if they're my papa, we go block road like that. And it's happy now.
So that's so you see him, eh?
That's so it be.
So you love the president more than your own brother.
Now my country, and apart from that, make I tell you, not the good heart where the president get will be like my own heart. So now make me understand that.
Yeah, this thing has happened now. Which one is they? Abba, why make they behave like this now?
Make I tell you something. Do as I say.
You know, Alhaji, I am thinking lately that we may have to call Mrs. Rahim and inculcate her into the business.
What? And why in heaven would you think of a thing like that? Mr. Uche, don't tell me you are becoming romantically involved with her.
No, this is... Alhaji, I don't have any such interest. I don't. But you see, she has been talking peace. She has been preaching peace all over the place. And she doesn't understand that we thrive better when there is confusion in the land. So I came to the conclusion that the best thing for us to do is to call her, sit her down, educate her, open her eyes, and let her understand the reason why she shouldn't be talking that way. I think we have to make her work with us.
I am terribly sorry, Mr. Uche. No, if you have noticed, I have very little to do. Or I try to have as little as possible to do with women. Because in business, I find them unreliable. Oh, yes. We will invite her in. She will see everything we do. She will learn everything we have. I promise you, she will report to the president.
But Alhaji, we can make her swear oath of secrecy.
No, my dear friend, I don't think I don't want that woman anywhere near us. I've been following her since she was director general of her last posting. And she is a committed person to due process. No, Mr. Uche, I don't like anybody who is committed to the enforcement of rules around me.
Well, Alhaji, if that is your conclusion, then I submit. You are the boss, and I don't have to counter whatever thing you said.
Well, I have decided to see her as an enemy. I think you should see her as such.
She is. She is an enemy.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on in. Hello, darling.
Oh, baby. It looks hot.
Thank you.
Just hold on. I'm impressed. You're making good use of the money I give you.
Oh, yeah? So, did you come with your aide?
I'm sure that he's in the car.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I shouldn't come in here with me.
Is this you, really?
So, I'll see you
right
now. Don't worry.
Don't worry. I'll do it for you.
Really?
Yeah.
No thinker. Small girl, now you don't want program with her. Now this small girl, you want to chew this small girl, you do grease.
Now what are you worried for her? Wait.
The hunter is now the hunted. What is this all about? Huh?
Do you realize that you're holding the Commissioner of Police against his wish?
Come on, keep quiet.
Kidnap or what? What?
Listen, Mr. Commissioner of Police. I have not brought you here to discuss the semantics of the law with you. And you must admit that you are helpless before me now. And then I will tell you why you are here.
Okay. Why am I here?
You are the Commissioner of Police in this state.
Okay.
And you are the one to implement the warrant of arrest issued on me. Okay. I want you to call your boss in the federal capital and tell him, convince him to withdraw that warrant of arrest.
If I should communicate the IG forward transmission to the CMC, it follows the process and you know it. And there's no way I can pass that information from here.
I don't remember telling you that I'm going to keep you here. I will let you go. You will go. But you must do what I want you to do. Do you know that I know your daughter who lives in Mina?
Huh?
Yes.
Oh God.
And I know your son who is a student in Abakeleke.
I'm finished.
I can always pay them visits.
Oh my God. No.
And I tell you, when Dombraya Silva pays someone a visit, he leaves behind trails of war and agony.
Please, please, leave my children out of this. Leave them out of this, please. See, whatever you people want me to do, I'll do. And I'll get back to you.
You don't have to get back to me. I don't want you to get back to me. I'll let you go now. But let me tell you something. Go back to your bosses. Tell them that Dombraye Silva is not the problem. The problem of the oil producing states is not Dombraye Silva. And then arresting me or killing me will amount to taking out one insect crying in the bush. Because another one, in fact, many others will begin to cry.
Mad for this stuff. Your grace, like the way are good. Now me go for my good, we are so good now.
Come on.
Idiots! Bring them here!
Doctor!
Shut up!
Brothers and sisters, must agree that this is a corporate victory for us. But this is only the beginning of our struggle. Mr. President has retracted his statement, and he has called for a stay of action on the matter. I'm happy, but I must say that that is not our ultimate goal. That is not our target. Far from it. Our ultimate goal is the control of our resources. The same way as it is done in every oil-producing country. And until we have taken control of our resources, the struggle continues. I'm not a mad, though. My head correct. I beg, let us drink.
The PPRO informed me of your people's coming.
Exactly. We are the press.
Okay. In the resolve of our command to zero in on militants and militant activities, we carried out a raid this afternoon on one of their hideouts. Luckily, we didn't even see them in their hideout. We ran into them trying to blow up a Chevron facility around Ukule.
Jesus Christ!
Shut up!
Shut up!
You think I'm here to play? Come, sergeant! Shut up!
You think I'm here to play? Sorry, gentlemen, for that.
No, sure, no.
We're running on them. If you look at these batteries, these are high-powered dry cell batteries. They were using it. The spark that is obtainable from the wrong connection of positive to positive and negative to negative poles, they were trying to use it to cause a spark on the Chevron facility. And it would have been a very outrageous blow-up.
Jesus!
If I hear your voice, I will stand up. I'm sorry once again, gentlemen. They were trying to use the spark obtainable there to cause a blow-up on the Chevron facility when we ran in there. You know, my gallant men and myself, we accosted them, overpowered them, about two of them ran away. We brought this few here. Immediately from here, we will move them over to headquarters for further investigation.
Well, I'm very, very sorry, sir. But sir, don't you think that these men here are very young to be militants?
Well, my gentleman of the press, you have actually spoken like the press man. And your naivety as it regards to criminality is expressed indefinitely, you know? There is no age brackets as it regards to crime. I don't know why we're looking at them, but I tell you solemnly, these are the most crooked of all the age brackets you can obtain in any militant formation. Do you know why? They are young, as you have noted out. And they play on our psychology, because when we see them, we tend to believe that they are innocent. And that is what they use. They take advantage of that psychology to do the real damage. Those sturdy-looking and hefty-looking militants don't come for the main operation. These are the people they send. And when we see them with their innocent looks, we tend to just pass them by. But today, any trained force man will always work on psychology. Today, we made use of our great psychology, and as you can see, it has paid off. As soon as we finish from here now, we'll move them up to headquarters for further investigation. Because we know that they are not the only ones involved in this. We know there are bigger men, men in high places that are funding them, supporting them, and we are resolved, we are determined to unmask them, no matter what it takes. Our CP is committed. All the men, the rank and file of this command, are committed towards eschewing militants and militants' activities in this state.
Criminal!
There's nothing you can do.
Thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, sir.
You will always come around. We will invite you in no further time because we are going on another raid. When we must have put them under interrogation, they will review the necessary information that we will use to arrest the main men behind this. We will call you once again so that you can take note of them.
All right.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you very much.
They murdered both my parents. Shot my mother inside the house. My dad. He tried to escape and they shot him in the back. He pleaded with me. He told me, he said, take care of Aduke. And I've done just that. I've been doing that. So why did I arrest him? He had nothing to do with this struggle. Why? Big bro.
Listen. You know they are always playing on our intelligence. And I've always told you that. Huh? Look, calm down. No matter what happens, they will never degenerate to the level of killing that innocent boy.
All I have is what I live for.
No.
If he dies, I don't finish.
No.
My life don't finish.
Listen. I want you to believe in your name. Tamuno itekena. Yeah, God answer my prayer. That's your name, man. Huh? Nothing will happen to that boy. Come on, take it easy.
Tekena Brazo. You have to realize that whatever comes up to a man is equal to the man. If you accept to go down, you go down. If you do not accept, you don't go down.
Don't go down, man.
Okay.
Huh? Come on. Brace up.
Welcome. Shark something. Akoresh. Kai kai.
Open your eyes. Open. Man.
Shark something. Shark.
Hey, water side boy.
Original BD. Shark something. Shark something.
Huh?
Go correct something. Shark.
Nothing. Nothing spoiled. Huh? Who not go? Not know as it be.
I beg your pardon, Alhaji Gambo. Did the president tell you that I told him to vacate his orders? Why are you angry with me?
I am angry with you because you are excited. Why? Why should you be excited over a decision that is very unpopular? You are misleading the president. Wallahi tallahi, I'm going to deal with you.
I don't like what you're saying, Alhaji Gambo. Who am I to mislead the commander-in-chief of this country? You are harassing me, Alhaji Gambo.
Look, why don't you give the president other news? Up and down the country is flooded and the farmers are crying. You have said nothing. Insurgents are filtering in from neighboring countries into the north central and creating havoc. You have said nothing. Kidnappers are everywhere, kidnapping people and demanding ransom from innocent people. Why don't you give the president information about those? Instead of just oil.
Allah Haji Kambo, you of all people know that the president gets his information from different quarters. Why are you, I ask you again, why are you harassing me, Allah Haji Kambo? Why?
Well, I want you to understand, if you don't already know, that oil sustains us. And we cannot, and we will not, play games with terrorists who are sabotaging our economy. To arrest them and put them away is the only answer. So you do the right thing. World leaders do not negotiate with terrorists.
You see, guys, we are men of action. We say less and we do more. This thing here is 20 million naira. And the money is for motivation. We want you guys to do something that will compel Mr. President to reorder the arrest of the madman. As we speak, too many idiots are coming into this oil producing area from the capital city. And that is because of the relative peace your weapon suspension strategy has ensured around this place. And that's why they are coming. We're not comfortable with that. We want you guys to heat up this place. Heat this place up so high that all these idiots that have paraded themselves as eyes for Mr. President that are coming here to poke their noses into things that do not concern them, we want them to scamper. You see, we make more money when there is chaos in the oil producing area. When there is confusion here, we make more money. And that is what we are planning to ensure.
So, in other words now, you won't make we cause katakata for the land.
It is not for free. This thing here is 20 million naira. You know, I understand you guys have significant monopoly over instruments of violence. I want you to explore that instruments. Understand this?
Miss Walaji can put a trial. See? That's how it be. When you call up a phone, you don't even pick a phone, just. The network don't reach his side at all.
But why are you still talking about Alhaji when I am here? I am his agent. Whatever thing Alhaji can do, you talk to me, I will do it.
Uche, don't be smart. As you don't reason as soon as so it be. You hear me, so? What you go do be say, you don't give me 30 million naira. May I tell you conscience?
This thing is 20 million naira here.
I say 30 million naira, 1, 2, 3 with zero for back. Not 30, if you know what, leave it like that.
Okay. Let me say it's settled, eh?
Thank you.
Alhaji, I'm not sure we have any problem with that. Before the end of business tomorrow, the morning, that extra 10 million naira will be available for you. We just want you to do something fast. We make more money when there is confusion here. And that is what we are concerned with.
No,
you can verify the money. It's
yes.
Complete.
Please. You carry the money, go inside now.
I'm sorry, officer, you're not making any sense to me at all. You are not making no damn sense to me at all. The first headquarters is waiting the arrival of those guys that we paraded as criminals. And you are still reluctant to have them sent to Abuja. Why?
I interacted with some of them after I met with the press.
Good.
In fact, I have the feeling that they are not the criminals.
They're not what? They're not the criminals? Jesus Christ. Are you now the judiciary that will decide whether they are or they are not the criminals? I wonder why you are usurping the powers of the court.
I'm sorry, sir, but I think it is proper for us to conduct further investigations before we have them transferred.
Are you out of your minds? What's going on here? Huh? What is going on? Now let me tell you something. Officer, do you know what I want you to do right away? I want you to go and have those guys sent to the headquarters immediately. What are you doing? What are you doing? See, let me tell you. That is the only way the IG will know that we are working. If you do not like your job, I think I treasure my job. Please, go and send me to Abuja. Please.
Begging you, don't kill me. I don't know anything.
I will slap you.
Please.
Shut up. I did not bring you here to kill you. I brought you here for us to talk.
Okay. Just tell me what to say and I will say it. But please don't kill me.
I want you to talk to your father. And when he has done what I want him to do, I'll let you go. Okay?
You know my father.
I know your sister as well.
Hey, God.
Why I am tolerating your excesses?
Don't push me to the wall! Don't push me!
Look here, Mr. Commissioner of Police. I am not pushing you to the wall because your back is already against the wall.
Do you realize you are talking to the Commissioner of Police? And that I can handle you recklessly?
And I don't think that you have realized that you should not be talking tough when you talk back to me.
And what does that mean?
Hold on. I want you to listen to somebody to explain to you.
Hello. Hello, Dad. Dad, please help me. I don't want to die.
No! No!
Yes. Yes.
What do you want?
Shut up. Listen, Mr. Commissioner. I want you to release all those innocent boys you arrested as militants. They have done nothing, and you know it. You will release them within 1 hour, or you will never see your son again.
The boys have been transferred.
I don't care! I don't care wherever they are. You release them from wherever they are, or you will never see this boy again.
Don't dare touch the boy. Hello? Oh, God.
Listen, what is it? Your instructions has been carried out, sir. The
what I wanna say is very important. No be when I talk my mind and go say I be militant. Water full everywhere, but not a drop to drink. Oil don't kill the fish, even the river they stink. We no fit fish, oh. We no fit farm again, oh. Some people come with some Oyibo, carry the money they go.
So far, they for Niger Delta.
Yes, sir. And if them no one listen to us, then go listen to us by force.
Justice and equality,
we want.
We follow get this country.
Yes, sir. And if them no get sincerity, no need for this amnesty.
Plenty so far, they for Niger Delta.
Yes, sir. And if them no one listen to us, then go listen to us by force.
Justice and equality,
now we want.
We follow get this country.
Yes, sir. And if them no get sincerity, no need for this amnesty.